around, guys. My name is John. I'm gonna play a few songs for you. Today's homework was to try two flavors of ice cream. So I tried the rainbow sherbet, which I didn't like so much, and then I tried the hokey pokey, which was pretty good. Still not as good as my favorite movie cinema gold popcorn caramel. Have you tried that one? It's fucking amazing. Anyway, the previous homework was to listen to 21 Pilots, and it was fucking awesome. So I went to see the gig and everything, and there was a song that I heard for the first time watching YouTube, and I didn't really like it at first, but one day I was driving in my car, and I heard the song, and I listened to the words, and it just thought just flashed through my head that I would play this song at my mom's funeral, and it just made me cry. So so I learned it, and just in case my mom dies soon. Cutest one. Like in eBay. But I put a pedal bear stick on the top for, you know, just in case. Shits and giggles. Yeah, so I used to be like a youth snob, and I think I'm starting to like this little thing. So do you want to hear another song on the uke, or should I switch back to guitar?
Use the
uke. Hey?
Use the
uke. Alright, okay. Well, I only know covers on the uke at the moment, so I'm gonna play another cover. And then I'll go back to originals on the guitar. and then I'll go home and I'll write some songs on the uke. For next time at the end. Great start, alright, here we go.
Follow you into the dark, the blinding light, the tunnel.
wine, the sour has collapsed in time, waiting for the hint of spark. But heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied. Illuminate the nose on their vacancy signs. There's no one beside you when your soul embarks. I'll follow you to the dark. As vicious as Roman rule, I got my knuckles bruised by a lady in black who held my tongue. Yeah, she told me, son, fear is the heart of love, so I never went back. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied, illuminate the nose on their vacancy sign.
Thank you.
Thank you. I recorded like a demo of the song and I brought it to her like 2 years later and now we're friends. On Facebook at least. She's not dancing anymore though, which is a bit sad for me.
She's doing really well, so that's good.
For her.
Wasn't that song on behalf of a friend?
Yeah. So the full story. So basically, I was born in Singapore, so I've been in the army in Singapore and all that shit. And this friend was visiting Perth, and I was like, you know, what do you do when you come to Perth? And I'm like, well, there's no strip clubs in Singapore, let's go to the strip club. And I said, you know, go see this girl because she's fucking awesome. You know, $50 go get a lap. This is like back in the day, right? $50 go get a lap dance. He had $180 in his wallet. She took all his money. She told him $50 you get naughty, $100 you get dirty, and $200 you get filthy. She's like, he says, I found the $180. She's like, yeah, I'll take that. And so I wrote his name. And like, so when he came, you know, he went in the room, and when every time he came out, eventually when he came out, we'll be talking, and if he's walking past, basically he just stops talking to me and just goes. And then the conversation continues. So I thought I'd write a song for him. Alright, story. So this one I wrote because I was running out of songs to write, and I just want to write something simple again that people learning the guitar could play around a campfire. And then I used the B minor chord, which is not easy for people learning the guitar. Because I'm a dick. Anyway, I wrote this on a Friday afternoon, but I'm gonna transpose this to I'm gonna be in the moment. Gotta be strong, gotta smile, gotta be the shoulder that you can cry on, gotta laugh, and gotta cry, gotta play the clown to dry your eyes. I can't always be that strong. Excuse me while I One, three, one, one, just one. Yeah, all right, okay, cool. All right, last one. We're gonna make it good, right? Well, this is my, I suppose, magnum opus. It was inspired by a poster, an Amnesty International poster that said, it just had like a little African boy with a helmet and, you know, African boy clothes, holding an AK-47, and the tag just said they gave me a gun, and I thought, like, that's a really powerful image. So this song is inspired by that poster and also the movie Blood Diamond.
Give me a gun.